Like continue fishing in Alaska. If you haven't seen, go check out my video about the how to get a premium for a week for only $1.50. I just bought it myself. I ended up looking up videos to find out where to catch all the fish, and the area for the Chinook salmon I found in the where I have recorded is the area for the Chinook. The area where we caught that one coho is the area for the coho, and the lure is the exact lure to catch the unique coho, and the lure for the Chinook is the exact lure to catch the unique Chinook. I just don't catch them. Other people get to catch them, but I don't. So I found them out just by asking and by mistake. I just don't get to catch them, so. Also, I found out where the other species of fish are located as well. I got the lures on me to catch them. I can catch just about everything except the sucker. I have corn. The long nose sucker. I have corn. I don't have peas. Video I saw that we're using peas to catch the long nose sucker. I've heard other people say use peas as well, so that was confirmed. I didn't see where they were catching pike or where they were catching black Alaska fish or whatever it is that's here. So I bought this Essential Predator pack. It's $1.50. I only bought it so that I could get premium, because 7-day premium is $7.99, but the 30-day premium right now is $7.50. So if I come over here, I have premium for a week, and I'm hoping to get a couple of levels while I'm over here. I have everything on me to get them. So first off, let's come over here to Angle in the Middle Earth. We're gonna click it. I'm gonna show you where all the other fish are, what lures to use, and I also found out that if you don't catch any fish, you might have to go into a private chat room. So this little area right here, this whole little area right here, has the what kind of salmon is that? Let me see if chat has caught any. Okay. All right, so chat hasn't caught any of that salmon that I'm talking about. It starts with an A, I think, Angora or something. And the bullet trout is here too. The bullet trout is actually right here, and you catch it with shad. And then I don't quite remember if I have to fish this way for sockeye salmon. Sockeye salmon is over here. And there was something else that was over here. So let's just try to catch something around here first off, so I can show you. You're gonna want to use a crankbait. I think it's 6 feet, 3-aught crankbait. I don't know why they're not stacking. So I'm gonna switch over to a 6 foot, 3-aught crankbait. So what you want to do is you want to come around over here. You want to cast just around this area. Go all the way down to one, if I could ever get a cast out. Alright, that looks good. Point it down and just crank it in without stopping. Actually, I think I want to get it over here on this side. I might have to scoot over. I'm going to let it float. I'm going to crank it. Bring it around this rock. Alright. Come and stand right around here. So let's do this a couple of times, see if we can get anything. I know there's multiple types of fish around here. Oh, there's these two. That one right there, Dolly Varden, should appear around here. Oh! Was that bullet trout? Trophy bull trout. Oh, bull trout. It's not bullet trout. So, this where these trophies trouts are, is where you can catch your unique. So let's just keep fishing this little area for now. The whole goal is to try to get it right around this. To go between the two stones, and that's where the fish spawn. They'll bite all the way up to the shore. And this is, oh, I caught it. I clicked the button right when he came around. So here's the Dolly Varden. Alright. So this is where the bullet trout, the trophy bullet trout, and the Dolly Varden should be. I'm going to try the same one, but I'm going to try to fish over here. I think this was where, forgot what kind of fish that was. I don't think I'm using the right lure too. Let's do the same thing. I'm just going to point it down. I think they were using speed 2, but I'm going to do speed 1. Just going to point it straight down. I'm also not sure if this is the same crank, if they were using a crankbait. Okay. Let's try it again. Oh, I think it was a sockeye, but I think they were using a spoon. We'll switch over to the green spoon in a minute. Alright, let's try the green spoon. Spoon. Medium spoon. I don't know if it was the medium spoon. Oh, I don't know which one it was. It could be this one. And was it over there or was it over here? Oh, I think he was standing right here and he was just casting this way. And it's nothing but lift and drop, I'm pretty sure. This should be for Sockeye. Oh, I got snagged again. I think you can catch them with nymphs. But I'm not too sure. I know that what I had seen was a spoon. I don't quite remember if this was the place. I'm thinking it was. It might have been over across from one. I know it's over here though for the sockeye. Might have been right here. I know it wasn't crazy far either. Oh, I got snagged again. I got a little coffee, so I'm gonna mute my mic, I'm gonna drink it, and I'm gonna keep trying to catch a sockeye while I'm here. Got one, guys. Oh. Oh yeah, that's a good one. Well, I'm glad they turned all the snags off, because this place would be bad. If you didn't know, there was a patch that came out that added snags. Just horrible. Trophy chum salmon. Ah, I went too far. I might even be casting it to the completely wrong area. Okay, so it's probably over here. Always make sure you check your drag. Believe it or not, if you leave your drag high, for example, I know I can go up one more notch, but if you keep it right when it's tense, you can snap your string. I'm also not sure if it's a morning or afternoon fish. Another snag. I'm gonna try to reel it in on speed 2 and lift and drop it and stuff on speed 2 instead of speed 3. I also might be using the wrong weighted, spoon. I'm gonna switch over to the heavier spoon. 2 ounce spoon. I know it's just around here, but I'm not positive if it's day fishing or not. Or because it's morning right now, if it's after PM, if on the chart it has fishing at dawn and then fishing towards dusk. Oh yeah. I just had to switch the size of my spoon. And dragging him all across the rocks. Chinook. Oh, I caught a Chinook all the way over here. Oh, that was strange. Strange to find a Chinook over here. Already got snagged. My string is taking a beating. I already lost 4%. So I'm thinking maybe it's right around here. I'll try it a few more times so I don't catch anything. I'm moving. Switch back to crankbait. So 6 foot crawfish crank right across this little area right here. Just put it on speed one, hold it down. Hold your tip down. Ooh, I got snagged. I'm hoping this whole area has something. Maybe I could find another spot where the fish are at. I know some people are reporting that they'll catch a couple of fish back to back, but then they can't catch anything else. And to fix it, you just gotta keep changing chat rooms. To go into like a private chat. I'm gonna give it one more cast, and then I'm gonna show you guys how to catch pink salmon. This is the area to catch the dolly, whatever it's called, dolly something, and the bullet trout. Just keep fishing it up and down with this crankbait. The bull trout. Oh, there we go. That looks like a bull trout to me. Yeah, bull trout is hiding behind that rock. So this little area right here is where the bull trout and the unique bull trout is. And this area, all this area, all the way down to here is where you can catch unique dolly warden. Because on the hints it says fish behind the rocks and stuff. And I guess that's the only area in the entire river. Oh, that's a crazy snag. I'm snagged up real bad. There is a fish right there, and he swam away. Oh, I don't know why I paused it. I paused it because I was hoping the fish would see it. So, to catch a unique bully, do a pear-shaped bobber. I don't know if this will work, but I'm just going to do what I've seen. Shiner with a 4-aught hook, and then just come around right here and aim right around here and go to speed 1. Jesus. Go to speed 1. I'll try to reel it in as fast as I can. So you see how the bobber is not really floating away? Like we kind of want to work it over here, right behind that rock right there, and we're gonna want to keep it there. There it goes. Oh man, I had too much slack. So that could have been my unique, and I just probably freaking lost it. I'm trying not to cast it like crazy. So let's do it again. Let's pop that bait right behind this stone. And you'll be able to catch unique bull trout and Dolly Barton. Dolly Barton will bite constantly right around here. I don't know if you need to have a specific bait, if shrimp bites better than shiners. Drinking my coffee, y'all. Alright, once it comes around, reel it in, cast it right back. Try to get it right back behind that stone. And you want to do it like on the low speed, that way you can just drift the drift the bobber right behind the stone, because that's where those bull trouts spawn. I'm wondering if, you know, they might be behind another stone or whatnot, because I'm thinking they spawn behind the stones. Try to keep it right here. I'm gonna turn my speed up just in case the trout bites. I can set my hook in a little bit faster, because I had it at a one, but since I'm holding it at an angle, I need the faster speed to reel in. There's a ton of slack. Oh, the fish bit. You saw that fish spawn and then swim away? All those are Dolly Barton too. Dolly Varden are pink, I think. Or that might be the sockeye. One of them is pink all the way. Yeah, it's the sockeye that's pink all the way. Oh, there's something there. I had a little blue light. There we go. There we go. There he is. Trophy bull trout. Just like that. So I'm pretty certain, let's try this behind this little stone. I'm pretty certain that you probably catch them with the crankbaits doing the same thing. Let's try this little stone. See if we can pull another bull trout out of here. Just to make sure that that's not the only area. you're gonna want to do a pretty deep leader, because if you do a long leader, then the bait actually touches the bottom and it keeps your bobber from just floating away like crazy. So let's try to work this little stone. Let's give it a couple casts. Prime time should still be around for a while. I think it got stuck on the stone. Nothing. Alright, let's go back to the regular stone. And just make sure you reel it in all the way. Just work the back of this stone. Snag that bad? There we go, it popped out. I think there's a fish or something there. Barbara's acting crazy. Fish pulled too far away. Let's tighten up this leader a little bit. Let's just do 45. I'm thinking it's because of the leader. Holy cow, there's a fish right there. Oh, unique bull trout. Yes. Yes. Oh, thank you, KP Shimino, for showing me that little guide. See if we can get another one. So yeah, I just had to straighten up my rod a little bit. Ah, there we go. Snagged up real good. Oh, I caught a fish when I was reeling it in. Bring this bobber all the way back over here. So I noticed that I need to keep my lines as straight as possible. Because when I point it to the side, I've missed all my bites. And when I try to keep it straight, I've caught two fish, and one of them was a unique. Oh, there was a fish biting it. Just put it right back here. Oh, the fish swam away. You saw that fish swim away? We'll put this down to 40. Just dragging that dolly warding right out the water. Oh, that big old bullet, that big old bull trout just swam away. Dang. Okay, let's try to keep this slack. Try to keep the slack reeled in. Try to get it right here. There's a Dolly Parton there, I see him. Oh, I tightened up the slack and swim away. Ah. Ridiculous. It'd be cool if I could just put my line right in there like that and catch a fish. So the bite chart is dead. I doubt I'll be able to catch anything until this afternoon. I'm still gonna try it. I think I read that those Dolly Parton said they'll bite the entire time, and the pink salmon will bite the entire time. I cranked it in and I had a little nibble. I'm gonna switch over to shrimp. I'm gonna try the same thing, the shrimp. Oh, I'm getting a bite. What is this? Dolly Parton. So yeah, looks like Dolly Parton is one of those fish that you can catch over and over and over. If you want to catch them, just come to Middle Earth and fish with shrimp. I'm going to try to catch a pink salmon. Pink salmon are supposedly all over the water around here, and you can catch them on shrimp too. So I'm gonna come around over here. I know there's a lot of chohos, a lot of chum all the way over here. So for example, like, even though I can cross the water right here, if I do this, put this down all the way to 14, put a shrimp, I'm gonna switch my hook size to 1/0, and I thought I had a different type of bobber. Let's change my bobber and put that there for now. Put a slim. Oh, bobber's still too heavy. It's fine. And just come up to the water and cast. And since it's not deep at all here, you should see the pink salmon jump up into the air if they do spawn. But since everything's dead, I'm not sure if pink salmon will even spawn. I'm just gonna reel it in. I'm gonna change spots. I'm gonna try up here. Try right here. Well, it looks like they're not gonna bite at all. I mean, the chart is all the way down right now. It stops, fish stop biting completely. Except I think they said Dolly Varden should keep biting and biting the entire time. You'll be able to catch normal Dolly Varden. But right now we're fishing for pink. Oh, look, you saw that? You saw that spawn jumped straight out the air? Yeah, it freaked me out. There we go. Here we go. So this is pink salmon. So I've caught pink salmon way all the way down the river. So pink salmon is everywhere, even in these little creeks. Pink salmon is. Oh wait, what's going on? What is this? 826. I don't remember this. Oh, this is partly cloudy. Oh, so the bite gets real high and then it goes down. Oh, I thought it was one of those that goes from here straight down and come back up. Did the weather change? Oh yeah, look, it's sunny on the top. But over here, maybe it'll change to partly cloudy. I understand they added weather transitions. So I'm just gonna toss it over here. For the pink salmon, I wouldn't recommend the 10. I did 14, I think. 14 inch leader with one knot hook and shrimp, all in the little shallow rivers. Well, anyways, let's do another pink salmon just so that you guys can see again. Just come to one of these little streams. They should be everywhere, but over here at the little streams, it's the water's not going like crazy. I'm already at 119 pounds. Wow, I didn't notice that. I need the bigger fish net. And if I start catching like trophy salmons, I can't keep them. I need to find that sockeye. I guess I'll leave the Chinooks for now because I can't keep them if they're more than 50 pounds. The most I can keep is 58 pounds, I think, and they get big. So we're just fishing for bull trout and Dolly Varden, a unique bull trout filled my thing up pretty good. I'm gonna fish for sockeye this afternoon. You see that unique Chinook salmon, 54 pounds. And my gear, I don't know what the max for that fish keeping. Let's see. Landing fish nets. 88, 661, 55. Oh no, this one. 68. So I could keep a unique. I've seen bigger uniques than that 54 pounder. I'm just gonna fast forward all the way to 3 o'clock. That's when, if it's sunny. Oh! Oh, God! Oh, well, that sucked. I advanced the day and it turned into here, and now the fishing is all the way over here. So, because it considered it a new day, I think it's right here. Let's switch over to the spoon, see if I can get a sockeye during the afternoon fishing. Which is, I'm gonna try this spoon. just need to find where all the salmon go. That's a bad cast. I'm pretty sure it's right here. Pretty sure this area is where the sockeye are. But because the weather and all that, and the server going over, rolling over for a new day. Oh, my dogs are barking. I wonder if there's somebody outside. I hear doors. I'm gonna stop real quick and see if there's anybody outside. I hear doors. I went outside to look, but I didn't see anything. Oh, I landed on that rock. You know what, I think I might be using this way too big spoon. As a matter of fact, I think my spoon is supposed to be, oh no, I don't have a 3-aught hook. Let me just try this. Yeah, I might have to use the 6/7 ounce. Let me try the 6/7 ounce. Green. Oh, it's still optimal. I wasn't equipping it because I didn't think it was optimal. I'm not too positive if this is the area or if I had to go a little bit more up. I'm pretty sure I had to go a little bit more up. I think this is the Dolly Varden area for unique Dolly Varden fishing it right here. I don't remember what bait. I think it was a crankbait too. I mean, the weather changed on me and it totally threw me off, and I don't want to advance it just yet. I'm thinking that the stockout was right between these two. Yeah, I think I'm just gonna advance the day. We're gonna start all over because the weather change messed me up, and I'm not gonna be able to catch anything. Yeah, let's extend it. So, trophy chum salmon, $104. Unique bull, only 11 gold. Okay, let's look at the chart. Says no fish until the afternoonish. Let's fast forward all the way to 3 p.m. Alright, still cloudy. And I'm already hit a snag. Hit another snag. I honestly don't remember. hit that crazy snag already. Another one. So let's go over there to the Chinook. It's this one right here, I'm pretty sure. Alright. For Chinook, come over here to Hunter's Cabin. Join the room. Walk forward. And I mean, I think you can probably catch it all over the place, but the hot spot is right around here. So come around here, come right here where the water meets, and you see those two trees? You're gonna want to cast this little area right here. All this little area. Just cast me over here. Do speed 2. And just reel it in on speed 2. Oh, is that a little bite? Yeah, that's a little bite. So that's area 1. Area 2 is you come all the way across, and then you stand on this side, and right across the shore there's some boaters. Aim at those boaters. I'm trying to use my space bar to cast, cause I usually just use my mouse to cast, but if I'm gonna be casting it and reeling it straight back, I might as well use my mouse. So it's just a matter of casting it over and over and over and over. You eventually get one. That's also the timing. You gotta make sure you cast during the right times. The chart is still low. I probably should advance it to like 4, but I'm hoping to catch just some regular ones. I'm not actually going for uniques. I'm going just for a lot of them. I'm gonna try to give it a little stop and go action. I've never really been too lucky on catching them on straight retrieves. So, since I'm not getting anything, and I know I should be getting something, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna make a private room, and I'm just gonna fish in the private room, because they said that I read in the forum that there's a bug with the fishing not biting. So here we go. I made my own private room. So anyways, that's spot one and two, right? This is spot three. Oy. And you can catch them with spoons, but I have this crankbait, and for me it's just a whole lot easier to fish with the crankbait. And down here is where you can catch coho too. The coho is just a green lure instead of the blue one. The other video I found a coho, and I had the right lures and everything. I just wasn't catching them because, like I said, it's buggy where you'll catch a lot of fish, but then it like glitches out. So what you want to do is you see that dead? You see how there's like a beach right there or a shore? And there's like a long pine tree and a little pine tree. Just cast over here. If you want Chinook, cast with the blue crankbait. And if you want coho, cast with the green one. And I think that's the only two that actually work around here. I'm just gonna do the standard straight retrieve with the crankbait. I don't fish straight retrieve personally. I've never been able to catch anything. Everybody swears by it. Never been able to personally. I'll get the oddball fish every now and then, but most of mine have always come from cast, pause, cast. I mean, a retrieve, pause, retrieve. Retrieve it, let it float up, retrieve it. And in Alberta I used to let it go all the way up and then reel it in. Let it go all the way up and reel it in. Let it go all the way up. But since there's a current here, the bobber just goes way off to the side and it'll leave the strike zone. switch over back to the blue one. Trying to get these Chinooks. Nothing. Oh. It's not taking it. Oh, there we go. Looks like a big one. 14, 13, 12. Oh, that's a big one. Oh, my first unique. And I could only catch it in a private room. I couldn't catch it in chat. So I get to keep him because he's right under the limit. My first unique. Shame that I had to catch him in the private room. But I did catch him just by straight retrieving it. And when the blue bar showed up, it was nibbling at it. And I was fiddling with it to try to set the hook. It wouldn't set the hook. It wouldn't set the hook. I kept right clicking. It wouldn't set the hook. So I'm guessing this. The time is coming where I can catch them. Since it just hit 4 too, and I was like, I should fast forward to 4. I was pretty surprised I caught that one. Once it started surfacing, I noticed how big it was. So I was like, oh, that's a big one. Let me see if I can get it in. I got real lucky. Because I couldn't set the hook. It didn't want to set the hook. We'll see if we can catch some more. I've seen people catch multiples. If anything, I'm just going to teleport back to the cabin and walk to the other two spots. From what I have heard is that once you catch them in certain areas, it'll get harder to catch them over and over and over, so you'll have to keep shuffling between the different spots so that you can keep catching them. So let's do that right now. Let's teleport back here. I'll try to use a public room again. Turn my chat screen back on. Alright, let's walk back over here. I know you could probably catch them over there. I mean, I've caught some. I don't know if you'll catch uniques. Do the same thing. It's a shame, because I'm wondering if I have to go back to private room to be able to catch anything. If I don't catch something by 5 p.m., I'm going right back to private. Because it makes no sense that I wouldn't be able to catch anything, even a regular one. Oh. Ah. I let the thing go. See, I think those are uniques, but they don't freaking take the thing. I shouldn't let it go. Yeah, that was probably another unique. That's how they bit twice already. Cause I know those uniques are over here like crazy. But I'm reeling it in. They don't bite it, and I keep right clicking it. Oh, there we go. See, that's how I'm used to it being, where it sets the hook. Oh. Man, that's a big one. Let's bring that big old... Uh-oh. Hope we don't break my line. My line already hit the yellow. Come on, baby. Watch me reel it in. I can't keep him because he's going to be over 60 pounds. The other one wasn't fighting like this. Just make sure you keep the meter in the yellow or slightly red. And don't go any higher or you'll pop the line instantly. I've popped so many lines because I thought I could go one more notch because the fish fighting was taking forever. I've been able to hold the right mouse button too. Oh, he's just a trophy. He's a big boy trophy though. Yeah, I'm thinking that fish that I missed the first time was a freaking unique. It mimicked the way the other unique was trying to bite the lure, where it was blue, but it never took it. I mean, I have no idea how I'm supposed to set the hook when it's like that. It's the first time I did it. What I did was I paused, and then I was reeling it in because I was letting the what's it called float up and down, the crankbait. And when I had paused, it just stopped biting. But I was over here right clicking. It wouldn't set the hook. So I'm wondering if I have to right click and left click. I would much rather find out how to catch them with a bobber than with this crankbait. only need two more Chinooks, and then I won't be able to catch any more before I get my keep net full. Oh, I hit a snag. Could have had two uniques. Dang it. I would play music, but I don't have anything that's royalty free. I do have Enderal. Enderal soundtrack. I mean, I could play it. I might. Because I'm getting kind of sleepy. It's 11:50 in the afternoon for me. I drank me a coffee, but all it did is make my head hurt. Can I walk across this right here? Yeah, let's come back down here to the end. See if I can get a Chinook, another one. Ooh. Man, I still remember when it was Christmas. I was getting them back to back to back. Big old fish, lake trout, and everything. It was amazing. Now it just seems slow. Look at my line. My thing is spinning like crazy. My lure. Ooh. So yeah, I don't know how to set the hook whenever it's blue. Since I rarely get to do it, I don't have practice. I don't know if I should keep reeling it in and right click, or stop to right click, or let it chew on it and then set the hook. And that, I'm pretty certain that's the unique that's doing that. That does it that way. Anything smaller, whenever you're reeling it in like this, it just sets the hook automatically. It goes from this to an automatic hook set, just like it did a while ago on the trophy Chinook. Just need two more Chinook. I can go to the next day. Oh, there's one. I made sure that the fish was hooked. And then I gave it some tension, and I notched it up one drag. And then when I'm fighting, I hold the right mouse button down. If I can. Sometimes if you hold the right mouse button down, it won't. It'll actually make it go into the red, which is bad. But since I kind of got a hang of these rods already. Like you see, like I let it go, the bars fluctuate, right? which is giving me a heck of a fight. Just gonna let it tire out a little bit. Hold that right mouse button. Ooh. Tension, server reboot in 5 minutes. Well, I better get this fish in. Feet, 13 feet. Got him. Another trophy. Yeah, I'm almost halfway there. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and end this one, since server's about to reboot. I'll probably stream again for maybe for another hour. I'll keep trying to catch Chinook, and I know where the long nose are. I don't know, let me see if I can get a quick long, so I can get a quick long nose before, before the game ends. So to catch long nose, you go to the cabin, you walk along the shore, there's this rock right here. I'm gonna switch over to my other rod. You're supposed to use peas. I got corn. I'm gonna try corn. And I think you can work with the number 4. Let me see. I think F11 does this. And that bobber looks bad. That's the water. I'll just drop it in the water. I can't even tell where my bobber's at. It's perfectly the same color. I don't know why they would make it the exact color that they use to paint the water. Look, you saw it? You saw it jump? That means it spawned. See if it stays. I see it there. I see it glimmering. Oh, there we go. Set the hook. A long nose sucker is what it's called. So you can catch long nose sucker over and over and over and over with peas, corn. I don't know what else. I'm gonna do these maggots real quick. Oh, I wanted to cast the other way. These maggots. Oh, there it is. Look, it's another one. I think it's that blackfish that I've been wanting to get. Oh, there it is. Here we go. Oh, it's another long nose sucker. So it looks like just long nose sucker are right here. I thought I could catch, there's this one called black something. Let me try right here. Alaskan blackfin? They were catching them with maggots. I got 2 minutes left before server restart. Hopefully server reset will do something with the game. I mean, I should have exited it out right now so I don't waste time catching other fish while the window is there. Nothing. All right, let's go ahead and end the stream. I'll try to re-kick it up at after server reset.